building work commenced late February 2015. It was estimated to be a 10-week project, but it ran into about 6 months. We had a lot of hiccups along the way, which is to be expected when you're working with a building that's 15 years, being empty 15 years. You know, it's a long time for a building to change in that time.
Nick had a clear vision as to what she wanted, and you know, that was, I suppose, a little bit different to what the builders might have foreseen would have been just a bog standard refurbishment. There was definitely very much a home from home feeling wanted for the retreat, which is quite right. That's what it's all about, a homely feeling.
The lodge which we're sat in at the moment will have a massive impact on local families and also families on a wider reach around the UK. The bespoke facilities that we've got here are a family counselling room, we've got a one-to-one counselling room, we've also got a function room so we can start to do some group activities with maybe bereaved children.
What they wanted in the space was that there was going to be the function space, and this would mean having an extension point back and knocking through, which was really interesting as we got into this existing building. And Nick was like, I want to take all these walls down. So that proved the first challenge of creating the spaces that she wanted.
We have two beautiful bespoke counselling suites, a smaller suite for a one-to-one person centred counselling. It's also a beautiful space to receive some wellbeing treatments and therapies.
The family room was quite an interesting one. I mean, you can't even begin to imagine what people are going through. You don't know, but as a mum, I can, you know, it's your worst nightmare. So all I could try and imagine was, if I was in that situation, what kind of place would I want to go to? And again, it was just a space that I could kick my shoes off, sit up on the sofa, really relax. And then you start thinking, well, that's okay as a parent to be able to talk, but actually that room needs to really, it needs to work for different people on different levels, different ages. So the children, for instance, in the family room, they needed the ability to really, I suppose, express themselves. So big feature wallpapers that gave that shabby chic feel, and they were okay for, you know, when a parent was in there and having a one-to-one. But then in the times when parents, you know, when children needed to be in there, it was that they could write on the walls and they could express themselves in that way.
Two-storey part of the building, we created a space for overnight accommodation. So we've got a beautiful living area with a bed settee and a chair and a TV unit and mirror, and it looks over at the retreat. It's got a lovely view out of it. A great bathroom with a huge shower, again donated. People have been so kind on this project, it's unbelievable. And then we've got a smaller bedroom that will host a three-quarter bed, so not huge, but it gives us a very welcoming space for guests and visitors alike, but most importantly, for our beneficiaries. We can now use the apartment to facilitate approximately 40 breaks a year, just short weekend breaks for a family of up to four, small family of up to four. That would be ample because it is a small space, but a wonderful, welcoming, gorgeous place to stay, and we'll embark on that early next year. We'll start to plan to book families in that space as well. Be well, trouble melts like lemon drops.
high above the chimney top, that's where you find me, oh, somewhere over the rainbow.
Phase one has turned out, after all the things that, all the challenges, all the things that we've had to do to get where we are, it's exactly how we wanted it to be. Everything from that first meeting that we decided was going to be involved in the planner, all the designs, everything Nick wanted, everybody's ideas, all of it has just gone in. There's been problems that have been thrown in the way, but all of it has ended up being exactly what we wanted it to be, what Nick wanted it to be, and what it should be. And it's perfect.
The transformation that has ensued is quite remarkable. It's open, it's airy, it's light, it's contemporary, but still keeping the old fashioned feel. Those original features being kept. And overall, it has been a really, really good project to undertake. We've learnt a lot, which will obviously help us on the next phases.
It's exactly how Nick visioned it. It's Nick, it's Reuben, it's Reuben's retreat, it's all the supporters through and through, it's everything that Reuben's retreat is about. It's quite emotional, really. The vision has been reached, and I know that people, it's going to do its job. It's going to support Reuben's retreat in helping people and making people feel comfortable.
I hear babies cry and I watch them go. They'll learn much more.
We've had a number of volunteers that have been and helped and plastered walls and you know, erased the paintwork and made it what it is. And I think that a building of this size and nature and age, you know, as with any building, you know, the goodness is absorbed in the walls, the history. What these walls have seen throughout the years has been phenomenal. And in the last 12 months, they've seen good. They've seen real, really good people come forward and help us deliver something for our families. And for that, you know, they'll always be a part of Reuben's journey, and we will always be indebted to them. We're so grateful, forever grateful, always.
Rainbow, way up high, the dream that you dare to why.
When your well is drying up like a desert into dust, and there's no rain on the horizon, I'll be there to fill your cup. Stops turning, and ever after. our bodies fall apart. A broken puzzle of the past. We can put it back together. 'Cause honey, all the good things last.
This far.